Hi, it's Navjot here. In today's lecture, we are talking on market basket analysis. It's our data science tutorial series. Market basket analysis is an important topic in finding out different association rules, and these are used in different businesses, especially sales and marketing. So before we study what is market basket analysis, now let us understand why is it important and why we're studying or discussing this. In order to understand why market basket analysis is important, we need to understand what is the objective of doing this thing. So basically, this improves the effectiveness of the marketing, and also it improves the sales tactics, because with the customer data which is available at hand, we can easily find out different patterns and we can find out the association rules through this. And MBA, which is the short form of market basket analysis, is a technique based upon this theory where we group the certain number of items and we are trying to find out the more likelihood of the group of items happening. It will also answer certain questions, which is, you know, which are the products which we are really interested in. So if I'm a reporting analyst or a data analyst who's working for a sales or a marketing agency, it is very important that I understand what is I'm supposed to find out from my data. So if there are some, you know, customers which are really interested in my products, there are certain products which are really important in us. Which are the products which are getting sold very well? What is the combination of them? There are certain combination of the products which are used in terms of, you know, sales, marketing, or some schemes. Or what are the hidden patterns which I'm getting through my transaction data? So this is something which is available through market basket analysis. And this, as I said, is to be performed by more of reporting analyst or somebody who's doing it to find out the interestingness of the patterns. So now understand what is market basket analysis. Market basket analysis is a technique or an algorithm which is part of the data mining algorithms, and it's used to find out the association rules from the given data. And when I say data, mostly it is used in transactional data or day-to-day data, which are huge in numbers, and there are some patterns which are not available through the open eye. So basically, it is something which we perform to get patterns which helps us discuss interestingness in the data. And there are two concepts which are part of it: the mathematical concepts of support and confidence. Support and confidence are similar to mathematics which we are studying in the high school. So support is probability of A given B, and confidence is given that we are having that support of a product given the other product. So if we were to understand support confidence in a simpler term, it would be that if there is a product which we are selling, let's say a mobile phone. So given a particular mobile phone and a list of mobile phones, how many chances are there a person coming to a store would buy that mobile phone? And confidence is the person buying that particular mobile phone, how many of them would actually buy the accessories also. Let's understand that with a simpler example. As you can see here, there is a transaction table which is given. There are five records in there, which has a day-to-day products from a shop or a supermarket. And we are trying to find out the customer coming to a shop and buying a milk and also buying a bread. So first of all, we'll have to find out the support for a person coming to a shop and finding that if he or she is buying the milk. So if you can see properly in here, it's having in the first transaction milk, second is milk, and then we can see the milk in the fourth transaction. So basically, there are three occurrences out of the five table data. So that comes out as in 3 by 5 into 100. That gives you the 60% support. Now the confidence is a parameter that given the person buying a milk, how many likelihood there is that the person will also buy a bread. So again, going back to the table, then we'll only have to three transactions, which is having the milk. And out of that, if you can see, 1 and 4 are having the bread. So the confidence is 2 by 3, which is around 66%. So this is how you actually find out support and confidence. So given that milk is to be bought, you can also associate the bread with that. You can come up with the schemes or the discounts there. You can put them, club them together in the rack. And this is how people have been using this. This all started with a survey which was performed in the Walmart study, wherein they find out through the patterns of the transaction data that there's a likelihood that person buying a diaper is also buying beer. So there's no logic associated with that, but there was a lot of likelihood found through the records. And then the association rule was saying that you can actually plan them to provide some discounts. So this is the basic introduction of MBA. There were also terms such as lift, which is coming into the account. There are other association rule mining algorithms, and there's a lot more to discuss on that. So we'll see that in the next lecture. Thank you so much for your time. I hope you understand the topic. If there are anything which you have as inquiries, please feel free to comment in the below section. Thank you so much.